broke.
Man. Broke?
Broke, guys. Say, I want a prenup.
The broke guys, they just want to know that you love him. They just want to know that you love him.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so if we reverse the things, yeah? And the woman is making less, and the man is making more, and the woman says, I want a prenup, does that become an issue?
I'll sign it both ways. Because the prenup is involving both of us anyway, so...
Because there's so many situations where, like, the guy makes less money, he's like, I want a prenup. And then the woman's like, okay, never was about the money for me, let's sign the prenup. And then when he starts to make more, he's like,
I don't need less.
I don't need you anymore. Oh, I'm such a high-value man.
High-value man.
I've, like, upgraded from you, so you need to leave my life. I want to know why that happens.
I think more in the sense, the people in the relationships just stray away from the reason why they were in the relationship.
Mm.
They're just now focused on, okay, yeah, it's all about the bag. Everything I can get with the bag.
Mm.
You didn't think about, okay, I was this person from the beginning
when
I was broke and everything, and now I've gotten up there. Instead of sharing it with your partner, you're like, I need to live the life.
It's always these people, you know.
You're such a calming voice.
Yeah.
Right?
She's just the peacemaker.
You really made me feel good.
She's like the peacemaker. I'm just, she's valid.
So
it only comes, I thought I would just say it in a sense that it's the social media that's causing all of this, you know.
Mm.
Have you ever noticed how a man, you can actually crush on someone, right? And then when you go out with them, you will see the other side of them.
Mm.
You feel me? Mm. You'll be like, hey, look at this guy. This guy goes to Burj Khalifa for lunch every day. Date him. He can't even take you to... Can you... What's the name of that restaurant there?
Seto Sham.
No.
Shit.
Bless you. That just sounds bad. Like, I don't know what you're talking about, but that sounds bad.
It's the cafeteria that's like, budget-wise, if you have 20 dirhams, you can get well.
Yo. Like,
that sounds like a good deal.
I know a story.
Right?
The lady will be like, this guy, I really like him. He looks rich. Can't even take him to bistro. And it's right there.
Conversation starter ever. You know how it feels, you know, how we pretend. Bring it up, it'll be alright. Like, you could see him, he has the six packs, he's got the abs. He's just.
He's all full of boodles.
He's biologically rich. That's all he is.
but
when you date him, he can't even pay for his taxi to go back where he came from.
You
went to go see him, tell him, he can't even take you to business, and you guys live here.
This is your yard.
Look at you. Like, honestly, it's all social media.
Okay,
that's just not
being it. Because if you don't have money, I don't mind. You know, if you don't have money,
I don't know.
Crazy. I know that people are like, oh, you shouldn't be dating broke guys. That's totally correct. But I just have a mindset where you're like, oh, okay, if you don't have money, cook, right? If you can't get money, find money. But if you're there and think, oh, I'm broke, then stay broke. I don't care. Me, I'll steal from you. I don't understand. Like, what do you mean?
The way you said it. You know that word. It has so much power. And being called rich.
Okay, listen. Okay, you stop laughing. You know, like, the thing people say where, like, if you want to date someone, know whether, like, you're prepared to do it or not.
Mm.
Like, it takes more than just, like, money in the investment of person. It's time, it's effort, it's giving them constant. But like, if you're gonna lie, then you have money, and if you don't show up with the money, then we have the right to laugh at you.
No,
like,
honestly,
we have the right to laugh at you. But if you come forward and you're like, I really like you, I'm not rich, okay, but I can make a sandwich.
Yeah. At least you're honest.
At least you're honest. At least we won't laugh at you in the
chat. Not those people who are selling you false dreams. You know, the sweet nothings that they call them.
Exactly. If you can't buy flowers, pick them.
Yeah.
Or draw them. Oh, you can make really good flowers out of paper.
Exactly.
Oh my
goodness. Origami.
Yes, origami paper. They're so gorgeous. And they stay so long. And like, yeah, it's true. Like a lot of effort and time. And like, there was one time where I made like an origami flower, and like inside the petals there was like little notes, so you could like open it and then you could fold it back.
So you have plants. Tissue, exactly. Yeah, if you wanted to, you would.
Honestly, oh, you could even make you could even make it out of tissue.
Exactly, I have.
It'll that. Still look good.
It's so pretty.
So it'll be thrown away. So, it's not that kind.
You're telling me.
It'll still look good.
If I did all this, if someone actually did all this for you,
mm-hmm. I would actually care.
Yeah.
No, like legit.
No, I'm yeah. so serious.
I'm so serious. Actually, mm-hmm. Yes.
Because it's the care and the thought that counts.
You put like, so you much. Can... It takes time and effort to mm-hmm. make those.
I don't want to be the religious person. Just bash somebody and be like,
yeah, true. Like
I can get that from my father.
I can get so, myself.
I just find it very crazy how, you know, we're students here, first year, and some girls expecting me to take them to Nazareth for the first time.
Cross the river, man!
Oh my god!
Did you have something like this?
I'm literally there. I'm like, I think that I'm please. Here with the rent and the groceries. That's all I have for myself, and you want me. You know, Nazareth, one beggar, that's my entire pocket, it's gone.
That's why you go with what you can afford.
Go with what you can afford. Yeah, what's enough? What you can deem enough, you know?
It always depends on the person mm-hmm. you're going for, actually.
Depends on the girl, too.
And you know how much. Can afford.
Mm. You can afford.
And be upfront with it.
Cause yes. Be upfront. Yeah. So say, oh babe, I can take you to Atlantis when you know all you can take it to is beggar key.
Honestly, yeah.
Don't do that.
Take it to Atlantis when the only pool is dancing, which is the one on the fifth floor.
No. Like, it's genuinely, be honest. So she knows that she's wasting her time with your knob. And so he knows. And
you,
so
he knows. He's wasting it. Guys, did you hear?
Can you let her finish before you?
So she knows if she's wasting your time and if you're wasting her time. Exactly. Because if she's out here being like, oh, I want to go to A, B, C, I expect a like 2-week vacation for literally like finishing my exams with Bay at some fancy ass bougie ass hotel at the 50th floor. And you can't. Book a room within the Myriads. At least if you communicate that, yeah?
Yeah.
It'll be so much better for you in the future, for your hearts, for your pockets.
Exactly.
For your time.
And at the end of the day, you know that, okay, yeah, this person's not for me.
And you keep it stepping.
Exactly.
So you guys are like the simple ones. You just want simple things and you want them to just be straight.
Be honest.
Well, there's a limitation.
Your definition of simple is like,
no, I'm saying like simple, like, hey, Charlie, let's go to for a first date.
No. Are you disgusting?
No. So you said it was simple.
There's a difference between being simple and putting absolutely zero effort. McDonald's is there. You can walk there every single day. Then you can walk there for your lunch when you're taking me out for the first date. Are you mad? Funny. Mm. Go back to your mom. I'm sorry. No.
I never get it. I should have. No, there's a difference between being simple and just being knowing your worth.
Exactly.
Knowing your worth and knowing what's worth your time. Like, I'm a simple girl. Let's go to McDonald's. Fine, let's have a chat. But we're having a chat, that's about it. That's about it. Like, the time and effort for the person is what makes people love the kid.
Oh, so yeah. If I came around with like a bouquet.
Okay.
Some rental euros over there waiting for us to go to some restaurant there.
Okay.
That's the effort you're looking for.
What's the point of the euros though?
No, I'm just saying you wanted effort.
Yeah.
So if someone just does
it count? Is that effort or is that splashing money?
That's why I want you to differentiate. Because I'm just trying to say, is splashing money making the effort or the being simple part? Is it different? Any different from being simple? Because when you're being simple, you're still spending. The peacemaker.
My thing is, if perhaps you're gonna take the girl out, you're gonna give her a bouquet of flowers, you're gonna rent a car, end up at the restaurant, have your nice time. Be consistent. Don't do it once or twice, then okay, I'm going to see the girl, and then like
after that, exactly,
like that's an empty. What are you going to do?
How do you expect that relationship to work?
And like you were saying, the money effort, right? And she has such a good point, exactly. You can't just, if you're going to do that once, you should be consistent with whatever effort. But then like, the effort doesn't also have to always be monetary value. Yes, you that money is a great way to show effort because money is time and time is money. So yeah, that's one way to put it. Mm-hmm. But then another way to put it, like, okay, instead of going to McDonald's, let's go to the beach. You take a picnic, you bought food, mm-hmm. you bought music, you know that she likes, you put, that's also effort. Someone mm-hmm. putting effort to make, to get a blanket and everything, put everything at nice.
You don't mind if I write this down?
Yeah, I know, I know you meant
to do that. If you need voice notes, let us know. Hey.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Shut fire!
What would you like to do? I was just asking general. I was just asking a general question. Because I was just gonna do this. I was just gonna airdrop it to my boy. Me personally, don't call me out as broke or anything. I said you men.
I'm a man,
not men.
I was talking to your half of the species, not you, but if you took that
personally. No, because you're looking directly at me. You're not looking at them, you're looking at me. Because
you're the only man.
We're supposed to look at you when we talk. Should we stare at the ceiling?
Hey. You look like no man's to you. Come on, react. Don't you even say yes. And I didn't take offense. I was just like, whoa! I just didn't expect it. Yeah. I never expected it.
Like the wonderful lady said, and she rightfully said, whatever you do, make sure it's consistent. Mm-hmm. You can start with like the paper towel flowers. Mm-hmm. Okay, she may not be that interested in you in the beginning. But the fact that you're capable of doing that often and capable of showing your care often is worth much more than a Bugatti parked outside taking you to some fancy place once every 5 months.
You guys, hear that? Once every 5 months, like, that is wild.
I don't know how you're scamming your parents.
Some people
scare me. But they're like, oh, I did that. I'm like,
oh yeah.
Love that for you, babe. Anyways, the point is consistency is so key.
Yeah.
In anything that you do, from the time to the effort to the money to the food spent. Mm. It's going to, like, imagine somebody's cooking for you, and then one day the rice is salty, the other day the rice is G, the next day you don't know whether it's pudding or spaghetti.
Too much salt.
So take that, apply to relationships.
If you want to change consistency, make it better.
Yeah.
Consistency, right? Consistency, if you're gonna be doing one-upsmanship with the Habibi boys, be consistent in the way they play as well.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when, because according to her, guys, be consistent when you're spending. Some of you guys watching here, you're probably hush puppies in disguise. Thieves.
Put that on the
chips. 40 thieves. A legend. The den of 40 thieves type of mandems. Thinking that you're spoiling them. Nah, you're stealing. You have rent to pay. Be realistic, guys. Get down to earth, like they said. Mm-hmm. You have rent to pay. You cannot live on noodles alone.
See, the interview was cut. Will not cut it.
Why is your blood on noodles?
Babes, I'm cooking tonight. Noodles. Is it a different flavor this time?
I mean, the noodles occasionally is fried. We're stupid.
This time it's Friday. It's a special day. We'll have the noodles with the spicy.
No, then today I'm adding eggs.
Today I'm adding eggs.
Today I'm taking it.
Today I'm adding soup.
Today is soup.
Oh, we're going out. What do you think? Noodles. Yes.
Noodles. if the man comes with noodles for the day, you become Netflix and chill with the noodles on the side.
And that's sometimes it's a fine.
That's so cute, actually. I love that.
Yeah, it depends on the vibe, but like, it's a vibe. Like, you that, that's like see, that's different. That's you on a date and everything.
So you're telling me that like, man comes here.
I don't want you to, I don't be like, oh, babe, what are you eating? I'm eating noodles. Every day.
Every day. Okay, every day. That's not that much. Maybe like make some sads or something. Like, you know, something rice.
Filling. Something filling.
Jollof, at least.
Pasta doesn't
A goosey wouldn't be so bad. And maybe you guys can also teach me some of those Cameroonian, Ghanaian. I know you guys like eggs a lot. I see that on TikTok.